have agreed, with which we have agreed. And you think you have to want more than you need. Until you have it all, you won't be free. Society, you're a crazy breed. I hope you're not lonely without me. When you want more than you have, you think you need. And when you think more than you want, your thoughts begin to bleed. I think I need to find a bigger place. 'Cause when you have more than you think, you need more space. Society, you're a crazy breed. I hope you're not lonely without me. Society, crazy indeed. I hope you're not lonely without me.
Hello everyone, good morning, welcome to Glencoe. You join me on a very, very cold morning. The temperature at the moment is about minus 6 degrees Celsius. Last night it dropped to minus 10 degrees Celsius, and in the morning my tent poles had actually frozen solid, completely froze together, and it took 15 minutes just to pull my tent poles apart. So I think this is the coldest day of the year, but I thought I'd come over to Glencoe because it does look absolutely stunning in this, in these conditions. I just got myself an energy drink from the garage over there, and the guy said it's forecasted to snow again today. So I wasn't expecting any more snow until Friday, but the Met Office, they might have got it wrong. So the plan is I'm going to walk from here through. I'm just waiting for that shop to open because I've got some sausages, haggis, and some bacon, and that's it. Oh, and some mussels. And that's the only food I've got. So I'm waiting for that shop to open. What's the time now? 9:30. The time is 10:20. And I'm on the minor road heading to the Clackagin. I've just bought a bit more food, so I'm okay for food at the moment. I was speaking to the lady in the shop, and she said, don't camp too close to the river in the Hidden Valley, because she told me the story of a guy who took his daughter wild camping there, and at 3 o'clock in the morning there was suddenly like a flash flood, and their tents got swept away, and they had to abandon all of their stuff in the Hidden Valley and then walk down to their car at the car park on the main road. So I don't think I'm going to be hit by a flash flood today though, but still I won't camp too close. It's not actually a river, it's more of a small stream. Well, it was the last time I was there, so I should be fine. The weather at the moment is absolutely stunning. Blue skies, sun. If it stays like this for 2 days, then I'm going to be a very happy man. All I need is 2 days of good weather like this. And yeah, I don't care what happens afterwards. So, I've probably got a 20-minute walk to the Clackaig. I'm going to get a big breakfast. I think they do breakfasts. Pretty sure they do. Get a big breakfast and then set off. Wow. I have never seen this area with snow before. The last time I was here, you could see mountain goats all around here, but I don't know, I can't see any. I don't know where they are at the moment. Right. The Clackaig doesn't look open, to be honest. So I don't think I'm going to be getting a breakfast. Those cars look like just the people who work here. Clackaig is closed until 11 o'clock in the morning tomorrow, so that's something to look forward to. I'll go in there tomorrow morning and have a coffee just to warm up. So I don't know why, but the temperature seems to be dropping the further I go into the glen. Or maybe because if you stop, then that's when you start to feel cold. But the temperature is definitely about -5 at the moment. Very cold indeed. Right, anyway, so I need to get around, probably. I know the routes without looking at Outdoor Active. Yeah, I'm probably about 2.5 miles, I'd say, from the Hidden Valley. And I guess it's a good job that it is closed, because I can get the tent set up, get dinner on, etc. So right, I'm not going to be stopping again for a while. Wow, that's a photo. The moon has just come into view over the other side of that. Not sure how well I can pick it up on the video camera. That is a good photo. I've reached the bridge that takes you over the river and up into the Hidden Valley. I can already see, I don't know if you can make out on the video camera, not the robin. Well, I'll zoom in on the robin as well. Beyond the robin, there's some deer up there. Okay, I'm safely across. Thank you to whoever put these here, because that really helped to come up here. All of that is icy, frozen. It's like walking on a bloody ice ring. Really useful, that. Right. carry on. They've seen me. Must be about 10 or 15 there. Can't really see from here. Here we are in the hidden valley. The time is 4 p.m. so it's going to be dark quite soon. I've got my tent set up down here. The ground is so frozen I can't get the tent pegs in, so I put rocks to try and anchor it down. I hope that works, because I do not want to be woken up in the middle of the night with the fly sheet being ripped off. I don't think it's going to be too windy, but if it was windy, yeah, it's not a good idea really, is it? But it should be fine. Yeah, I've got everything set up. Got my airbed, sleeping bags in there, a snug pack extreme sleeping bag. I think it's a three or four season one. It's got a comfort of -7 and an extreme of -14. So I should be fine. I was nice and toasty in it last night anyway. Right. I'm going to get dinner on. But first, I'm going to have some buckfast. Oh, it's frozen solid. Oh no. Yeah. That should keep me warm. Well, alcohol lowers your body temperature, doesn't it? But it makes you feel warmer. Just gives you some Dutch courage. Dinner is served. Some beef ravioli, 4 pieces of haggis, and 2 sausages. And that's my TV. Right, I'm going to eat this so quickly, I'm starving. Temperature is about -4, -5. And it's going to drop to probably -12 up here. So I'm at the extreme limit of my sleeping bag. The time is 6:10 and I estimate the temperature is -15°C. My sleeping bag can't cope with these temperatures. I'm in all of my clothes and I'm inside it and I still feel cold. It's not warming up. So I've surpassed the limits of this bag, basically. So I'm in for a rough night. But luckily, I have some buckfast to take the edge off what's going to be a terrible night. I'm probably at 1,400 feet here. So I'm basically camping on the Worcestershire Beacon in Malvern in the middle of bloody winter. It's got a bit steamy in here. I'm having my second dinner, which is Scottish mussels in whiskey sauce. Sorry, the camera's got all steamed up. Is that any better? Look at this. I mainly just cooked it so I can drink the broth, because that will be lovely in this freezing temperature. I have got a few more packets I'm not going to cook the rest. You can't really see because of the steam. Delicious. I enjoyed those last ones so much, I've decided to cook the lot. But I've probably got about 50 mussels. So I've removed them from the shells, so they cook quicker. And that sauce is absolutely brilliant. It's steamed up again, so you can't really see that well. But there you have it, mussel soup. There's probably about 50 mussels in there. And there's a lot of that whiskey sauce broth. That's going to warm me up a bit. I think it's warmed up the tent as well. Only slightly. Hey everyone, it's 7 a.m. I've pretty much had enough of this. It's been 14 hours of torture, to be honest. I think I got maybe an hour's sleep, so I am getting out of here. The entire tent is frozen solid. I'm gonna have a quick breakfast of some Jaffa cakes and then I am out of here. The time is 8 o'clock. I'm all packed up and ready to go. I'm just going to take it easy to begin with and wait for it to get a bit lighter before I go on to the gorge bit. It should be dark in, I mean, should be light in, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes. This is the place where I should have filled up with water last night. I am so dehydrated. Oh wow. I've been looking forward to this for about 10 hours. Proper drink of water. So this is all ice here. It looks completely different when all of these trees have lost their leaves.
When I walk beside her, I am the better man. When I look to leave her, I always stagger back again. Once I built an ivory tower so I could worship from above. When I climbed down to be set free, she took me in again. There's a big hot sun beating on the big people in a big heart. She comes to greet me, she is mercy at my feet. Yeah, when I see her pin her charm, she just throws it back at me. Once I dug an early grave to find a better land, she just smiled and laughed at me and took her blues back again.
Beep.
The robin didn't get all of my lunch. 2 packets of Danish and Milano salami. I need a couple. Well, everyone, this is where the adventure ends. It has been a bit of a crazy trip in terms of the temperatures. It was minus 10 degrees Celsius in Glencoe, and then as soon as I climbed up into the Hidden Valley, I reckon it was definitely at least minus 14, because that's what my sleeping bag, a snug pack extreme, can withstand. So I was at the limit of what my sleeping bag could cope with. But apart from that, I had pretty good weather, as you've seen. It was just the temperatures, but to be honest, I did choose to do it on the coldest nights of the year in 2024. Before I forget, Dad, happy birthday. Thanks for watching, if you've actually watched this. And thank you to everyone else who have watched The Hidden Valley. And I'm signing off with an original Scottish premium beer. Cheers. Once again, thank you for watching. And until next time.